Welcome to Der Springen Poppen Garage, where we take old pieces of shit and turn them into less shitty pieces of shit.
It's your boy John from Der Springen Poppen Garage, here to talk with you about cars. Now, not every car I own is an old piece of crap. Some of the cars I own are newer pieces of crap. Like this, my 2006 Subaru Forester with a 2.5-liter four-cylinder flat motor. Now, this car I bought at the beginning of the summer from a friend of mine moving out west for $1,600. 177,000 miles, recent head gaskets done on the car, and a little bit of recent work, and the prior owner had done his fair share of keeping the car maintained. Now, $1,600 is not a lot to pay for a car, and I refuse to pay any more than $5,000 for any vehicle. Every vehicle in my fleet, that's eight cars, costs less than $5,000. But that doesn't mean that I get away scot-free without responsibilities. There's a lot that has to be done to make sure a $5,000 car or less continues to run and runs for a long time. And it's really not that hard to take care of those little, stupid things that can potentially turn into massive issues. Let's talk about that. $1,600 was the purchase price of the car. That doesn't include $300 of registration and tags, and it doesn't include the repairs that the car required, because you can imagine, for $1,600, there's got to be something wrong. Fortunately for me, the prior owner took good care of the car and already had addressed some major service issues. Now remember, on an 177,000-mile car, you're going to have major issues, and it's great when you have a prior owner that's already taken care of those issues, because then you don't have to worry about it. That's why service records, when you're looking at a used car, are great to have, or if you don't have service records, you at least know the owner, either personally or professionally, or someone who you know took care of the vehicle. These are important things to look for. Now, I've never owned a Japanese car in my life, but I decided for $1,600, it would be worth the risk to check out this 2006 Forester. I mean, it's got everything that you could ever ask for. All-wheel drive, a fuel-efficient four-cylinder motor, a gigantic electric sunshine roof. Just look at how big that is. And that slides all the way back. You've got beautiful glass and great visibility all around. This was a great year for this car. Lots of visibility, great storage, great features. You've got electric windows, electric adjusted seats, electric heated seats. I've got an aftermarket stereo in there. We've got cruise control, power windows, power locks, power mirrors. When it comes to modern conveniences and storage, this car really has it all. I believe even if I just drove it for 6 months, that $1,600 was well worth it. So what kind of issues did I have to take care of when I bought this car? Well, for one thing, the alternator was faulty. We had bad bearings in the alternator, and not only that, but the voltage regulator inside the alternator was not giving a sufficient charge to the battery while running all of the electronics inside the car. As you already know, modern cars have a lot of computer systems that manage the engine, manage the climate control, manage your stereo and entertainment. So it's really important to make sure that your electrical system is all right. Fortunately, on this Subaru, the alternator is just at the top, and it was maybe an hour job. The replacement alternator cost $100. I'm a big stickler for making sure that suspension on a car works well, because if your suspension is worn, the car's not going to handle appropriately. And if you're in ever a situation where you have to do evasive maneuvers to avoid a collision, you're going to want your suspension to be tight and responsive. That's why I find there no excuse to have any issues with suspension. So this car has sway bar bushings that were completely worn out. And sway bar bushings help with the lateral roll of a vehicle. The sway bar bushings were worn. Those were easy to replace, $20 each all around. So $80 to replace the sway bar bushings and literally 20 minutes of work each side. The real pain in the ass problem with this car was the noisy rear wheel bearings. Now, wheel bearings are what help to make your wheels roll smoothly. When they start making noise, it means that the bearings have worn out and they need to be replaced. To me, this is not something I can ignore. because eventually if those bearings seize, then your wheel seizes. What happens if you're going 65 miles an hour down the highway? Your rear wheel seizes. Well, you've got a problem, and you could potentially roll over the car and kill yourself. So we had to replace the entire hub carrier assembly, which was not just the wheel bearing, but the entire piece that attaches to the wheel to a hub. It's essentially the entire wheel hub. That was about a four-hour job each side, $1,000 worth of parts. So what are we up to now? We're up to $2,600 plus $80. So whatever $2,600 plus $80 is how much I've spent repairing this car. Overall, I think $2,600 or almost $3,000 for a car in such nice condition was really not a bad deal. What was great about buying this car was I've learned all about Subaru engineering and what it takes to fix a Subaru. And that's one of the best parts of Der Springen Poppen Garage, taking chances and challenging ourselves, well, really challenging myself, on a new vehicle and seeing what it takes to make it operate optimally. And I hope you really enjoyed my video. I plan on doing more of these Der Springen Poppen videos where I just give you little tips and pieces of my experiences with cars, and I hope you enjoy. If you have any questions, you can just message me.